would also like to focus on at this point is the strategic investors from overseas. We've yes. seen the investors, financial investors really come in, but what's really holding back the strategics? Are we seeing that trend emerging in any of the sectors?
We're seeing it, so we are. But, you know, I think that it's not been as frenzied and as hectic as it has been with the financial investors. So a lot of our strategic clients are looking at India. All of them have existing, some of them have existing interests in India. The bulk of that is actually happening under the radar. It's not necessarily being, it's not in the public domain because most of these are unlisted companies and therefore, you know, nobody really knows about these acquisitions. There is work. There's a lot of things happening in the with strategics, but it's smaller deal size and, like I said, it's under the radar.
All right. And as far as the strategy and focus of Shardul, Amarchand, Mangaldas is concerned, where are you focusing on at this point? And in terms of competition also, how are you seeing yourself?
Well, I mean, you know, at the moment, quite frankly, there's a lot of work. There's work for everybody. We've been very fortunate that we've had a really good growth trajectory over the last 2 years, both in Mumbai as well as the firm across the country. We're not really worried too much about the competition because, as I mentioned, there is enough work for everybody at the moment. What we're trying to do is focus on special areas of practice, particular areas of practice. And for us, it's all about quality, quality, and quality, you know, giving our clients the solutions that they want. So it's not about numbers. We're 500 plus lawyers today in India, which is a very good number. We've reached a critical mass in terms of our size. But really, it's only about making sure that we're able to deliver the excellence to our clients.
All right. So there's a lot of fair bit of competition, I would say, and also spurred by the split in the large law firm also, which you are a product of. But as far as the deal street is concerned, for this year, Akshay, it has hit a six-year high. But in the last quarter, it took a slight bit of dip. How are you seeing the overall year?
So I think the year will actually, I mean, if I just look at the amount of deals that we are trying to close before 31st December, my sense is that you will see that that dip be picked up. So you're going to see quite a lot of activity. You know, generally speaking, around Diwali, things tend to slow down. And then you see a lot of activity before the end of the year because, you know, most people want to sort of shut shop around Christmas. So in the next 2 or 3 weeks, you'll probably see a lot more announcements than you have over the last 2 or 3 weeks.
And has to be before 15th of December.
Generally speaking, before 15th, 20th December, yes.
All right, so I'll be very occupied. Thanks for that heads up, really.
You will. Like you have been today with the news earlier today.
All right, so you're talking about access. But I definitely want to ask, is there any new trend otherwise that is emerging from the ones that we are seeing right now? And in terms of capital market transactions also, you think the deal street is going to be equally active?
Yeah, I mean, you know, if markets continue going the way they go, I mean, the appetite, I mean, there's clearly appetite for good quality IPOs. Like I mentioned, I believe that there's been about 30 IPOs this year, which is, you know, which is quite phenomenal. So I think that that will continue. In terms of trends, we've discussed them before. M&A is kind of driven by consolidation, by, you know, sort of delevering balance sheets. To a certain extent by regulatory constraints, but that's not as much of a driver of M&A activity as the first two, which is consolidation and delevering.
One question I forgot to ask you in the beginning when you did speak about the greenfield is how much time are you giving for the greenfield you know, projects to really come in? That is, private investments really picking in.
Are you talking about in as in for our clients or...?
No, overall in corporate India, the larger corporates, and especially in infrastructure that you alluded to.
Sure.
So when are you seeing the greenfield operation, the private investment really coming back? Because that's something that has really not...
So it's already happening. I mean, you know, I'm privy to several of our clients that are looking at, that have plans to put up new facilities. So I think over the next 2 years, you will see... that there will be some fresh greenfield investment. Also, the states are you know, sort of chasing investors. They're sort of facilitating business. Maharashtra, for example, is a case in point, how they're, you know, really trying to attract investment into the state. I know that some of our clients have been looking at Andhra Pradesh, for example, Rajasthan, across the board.
All right, Akshay. Thanks so much for joining us on CNBC TV 18, and all the best for your future deals as well. Thanks so much. Thank you. Thanks for having me. Thank you.
Thanks. Bye.
All right, with that, it's a wrap on this edition of Big Deal. Deal Street is going to be buzzing. Big deals have been announced this week and many more to come before 31st of December. I'll keep an eye out for that one. You keep it with CNBC TV 18. Thanks so much.